Everybody, I'm Ryan.
This is Josh.
And we're from LostReviews.com, and this is Blue Monday. First up on Blue Monday, we have the Disney release of Secretariat. Now, this was one of those movies that I'm not sure a lot of people saw, but
I didn't have the chance to see it myself.
Yeah, you didn't even get to see a chance to see it on the Blu-ray that we have here. But it's, you know, just one of those copy and paste Disney films. I'm sure you can even tell that from the trailer.
Oh, I knew what it was. I could tell you the exact synopsis of the entire story.
Yeah, you really don't need to see the movie to know what it's like. But it's all these movies are really about the feeling that you get at the very, very end when, you know, like they did with the Mighty Ducks, when the team, you know, wins and all the underdog comes through in the very, very end. You all tear up and everything happens. It's great. But this is Blue Monday, so let's talk about the disc. The picture is crisp, 1080p, everything you'd want from the movie. The real standout from the Blu-ray is the sound. The sound of the races, and there's this one great scene where thunder's rolling in, and really piqued my attention for the sound, and the score sounds fantastic on the Blu-ray. And this thing, just like Disney always does, it's packed full of special features, interviews, commentary, just everything you could want. If you enjoyed Secretariat...
Or you're just an equestrian lover.
Yeah, definitely. If you like it in the theater, you're into horses, definitely check out Secretariat on Blu-ray. I am going to give it a rent it.
I'm going to give it I haven't seen it.
All right. That's a new category now. So next up, let's talk about Nowhere Boy, a Blu-ray that you did see. Mm-hmm. This is one of those overlooked films, and I'm not sure really a lot of people know.
I think they messed up on the PR, because this film...
Yeah.
It's John Lennon, and of course the Beatles are the biggest thing since Jesus. So, really, if they were promoted this more, this would have been a huge film, and it really deserved, because the story is fantastic. It gives you a chance to see the Beatles and John Lennon from different sides. I think at certain points you could sit there and just see this is a pop band in their early days, but they really went through a lot, especially John Lennon. His family life was extremely tough, and you get to see all the hardships and what made him to be such a genius.
Yeah, all the stuff that, you know, all the pain that you feel in his songs, you see why.
Yeah.
It's all there in
exactly.
Nowhere Boy. The thing that's really, I think, one of the best things about this film is Aaron Johnson. Kick-Ass. He is fantastic.
And he got buff.
Like, yeah, he looked really good.
Yeah.
He looked really
fantastic,
good.
Fantastic. The acting in the film was superb.
Yeah, all over the board. The Blu-ray, the picture is crisp and clear. I actually got a chance, I watched this first on my laptop, and then, you know, watched it back at home for, you know, more enhanced picture and sound. And the score on this is amazing. There'll be, you know, an orchestral score, and then you'll see kind of John Lennon kind of space off, and you'll hear like bits of guitar come through. And it was really impressive to me, and there's all these subtle things with the sound that I was highly impressed with. There's not very many special features here, but that's not you know, uncommon with indie films.
It felt like in like a little 15-minute clip they have of HBO between movies. It was really brief, and you didn't get to see much.
I would have liked a commentary. I think digging more into this film and the history of it. We
I
do have
to know
one
the fact checking. Yeah. How do they know so much about him? How messed up his life is? Because it seemed like I'm sure it's true. You know, I really don't doubt it, but that would be tragic if it was all true to how screwed up that poor boy's life was. I mean, at the end, you know, he became John Lennon. But, I mean, they even have this line, I want to say, he's talking about Elvis. He's like, why wasn't I Elvis Presley? And his mom tells him, because you're going to be John Lennon. He's like, damn God. And the point is, like, you don't understand. You're John Lennon. I mean, seriously, it's really a powerful film, and the dialogue's so
good. I know we're running a little long on Nowhere Boy, but I enjoyed the little tagline at the end, and it's even in the trailer where, she says, what's the name of your new band? And he says, doesn't even matter. Mm-hmm. And I just enjoyed that. I enjoyed Nowhere Boy. I would definitely give this a buy it. I would go buy this Blu-ray.
I would say if you're into more of the indie films or just a Beatles fan in general, you need to buy it.
Yeah.
People are Beatles fans.
If you're a Beatles fan, if you're into acting, go check this film out. Last up, not a Blu-ray, but a documentary, and this one hits very close to home. It's What's the Matter with Kansas?
That's really this hits close to anyone who lives in the nation to me.
Yeah, so I'll let you head off on this one.
I'm going to head off on this. First of all, this is going to become very political. So if you're not into politics, or if you're on the right, or if you are a hardcore Christian and you have trouble, you know, really defending your own beliefs or have people challenge them or question them, you might want to click off now. Because this film was, honestly, it was a left film. It was really a very liberal film that shows to how it portrays the insanity of
the Midwest.
The Midwest and just the Republican Christian Party. And there's the hypocrisy of it. And the fact that it's just kind of sad at the end of the day. These people, for the point of view of the film, it's just showing these people are just so scared not to have a God because they need their answers. And that's what really the entire film is about, is just, they portray it as just the insanity. I would say it's definitely not a bipartisan movie.
No, definitely. And a lot of the stuff that you're talking about comes from the story of Wild West World and how this guy pretty much took advantage of all these people, telling them that they would have a church and a theme park where they could, you know, bring all these thousands and thousands of people that would come to this theme park in and, you know, basically convert them into members of their church.
No, to me, it was just a scam because they had people invest in this Wild West World, which would be an amusement park and a church, and it failed. The guy took the money and then filed for bankruptcy and split the road.
Yeah.
But really, that's what I'm going to get to. There's no point to this movie. I feel like they're just sitting there and saying, okay, let me show you a Christian conservative that's a little wacky. You live in America, you've seen that. I mean, it's not constricted to Kansas, it's not constricted to Kansas City, it's everywhere in the nation.
Yeah.
We've all met one or two of them. And if you are that person, I'm sure you were a pleasant person to share tea with, but we just don't share the common interests in politics.
And honestly, we live in Missouri, but we're very close to Kansas, and there was a liberal farmer that Josh couldn't even believe was real.
No, he was extremely well-spoken. I felt like they almost got an actor to come play the left, because it was all right, except this one guy on the left who was just a farmer, and of course, you know, he was dealing with big corporations that are taking out little farmers, like a lot of people know, like Monsanto, for instance, and he goes to Washington to fight the corporations. Of course, doesn't really succeed, and he does end up losing his farm, spoiler alert, I guess. But yeah, it was touching. And
I don't necessarily think they said that he lost his farm, but he was on the verge.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and he...
No, he said unless his children came.
Yeah, and he wasn't going to push that on his children. I think that was why the reason, like, you're like, this guy can't be real.
Yeah.
But the documentary...
No, he was so well-spoken.
Where the documentary fails, though, is the fact that it never grabs its legs. I feel like what they were trying to do was just explain Kansas to the world, but really all they were doing was explaining Christians to the world, I think.
Explaining... I don't know, maybe, gosh, you know what, you're absolutely right. They're everywhere. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
It sounds really horrible to put it like that.
It's not just Kansas.
It's religious fanatics. But the only thing documentaries should have a point, in my opinion, because documentary films, to me, seem to try to, you know, change the world opinion. But that really was just, here's, you know, a few things and not really a point to it. And that's where I really fell behind. And the fact that it should have tried to show at least, the other perspective of the right, like, why are they like this? Instead of just showing to be so these
it's
loons.
A very slanted film. It's slanted towards people like us. Though it really never got its legs and never made its point, I wish we would have heard more things about how Kansas used to be, you know, more open thinking and socialism and stuff like that, because I felt like that's what they were trying to get at.
They were just trying to show their hypocrisy, that there was a huge newspaper that was bigger than the Times, but as we know, people probably read more back then, and it was a socialist newspaper, and it was really huge.
And you know, I would have liked to hear more about that, but it never got there. I was entertained by the movie. I'm going to give it a rent.
I'm going to say skip just in the fact that you can get any of this by watching a thousand other documentaries, just sticking to a Real Time with Bill Maher on Friday night. Same stuff.
All right, that is it for Blue Monday, and I would like to thank Josh for coming on this week, and we'll see you next week.